In question number 11, magnetic field on the axis of the ring is 0. Therefore, magnetic field due to wire and magnetic field due to ring will be equal and opposite. Magnetic field due to wire is B cos theta in horizontal direction and B sin theta due to B sin theta in vertical direction. Net magnetic field in vertical direction will be 2B sin theta. Horizontal component of magnetic field be cancel out. Therefore, by replacing the value of B, mu naught I 2 pi under root of A square plus H square, which is the distance of the wire from the point P, and sin theta. Sin theta is A upon under root of A square plus H square. Therefore, magnetic field, net magnetic field due to wire is mu naught I A upon pi A square plus H square. Magnetic field due to wire is mu naught I A pi A square plus H square. Magnetic field on the axis of the ring is mu naught I A square upon 2 A square H square ki power 3 by 2. By equating these two equations, we will get A H is equals to 1.2A. Therefore, answer of this question will be C. And magnetic field, current in both the wire is in opposite direction. Current in wire SP is inward and current in this wire is outward. Therefore, answer is C. Net torque on the ring will be equals to M cross B or MB sin theta, where M is the magnetic moment of the ring, which can be written as I into A. I is the current in the ring and area of the ring is pi A square. Magnetic field due to both the wire is in inward direction. Magnetic field due to this wire is in inward direction, and magnetic field due to this wire is also in inward direction. Therefore, by adding these two magnetic field, we will get mu naught I over pi D. Now, by substituting the value in the formula, we will get mu naught I pi D multiplied by magnetic moment I pi A square, and sin theta is 30 degree. As the ring is rotated by an angle of 30 degree, area vector will make an angle of 30 degree with the magnetic field. So, angle between magnetic moment and magnetic field is 30. By this, we will get mu naught I square A square upon 2D, which is option C in the, option B in the paper. Therefore, answer is B. In question number 13, there is diatomic gas in the upper part of the cylinder and monatomic gas in the lower part of the cylinder. These walls are insulated walls so that heat cannot exchange from the surrounding. Heat exchange from surrounding is zero. This piston is movable and separator is fixed. Now, when for a gas A, process is isobaric because this piston is free to move and the pressure at this piston is constant. Therefore, for the process A, heat supplied is QA. And for the gas in chamber B, process is isochoric. Because this separator is fixed, volume of this cylinder is constant. Therefore, process will be isochoric. And heat gained by gas A is equal to heat lost by gas B. Therefore, QA is equals to QB. And as we know, process in gas A is isobaric. Therefore, NCP delta T. Delta T, final temperature of the gas is unknown, so we will take it as T, and the initial temperature is 400 Kelvin. Now, for gas in chamber B, we will write N, and the process is isochoric. Therefore, CV and change in temperature will be 700 minus T. Now, number of mole for the gas, both the gases 2, and Cp, gas is diatomic, therefore Cp is 7 by 2 R T minus of 400 plus number of mole is 2, Cv for monatomic gas is 3 by 2 R and it is 700 minus of T. By solving these two equations, T is equals to 490. By solving this equation, we will get T is equals to 490. It is option D in the paper. So, answer is D. For question number 14, this separator is free to move and pressure in gas A, chamber A is equal to pressure in chamber B, means both the gas will follow isobaric process and heat gained by chamber A is equal to heat lost by chamber B. The QA is equal to QB, but both the gas will follow isobaric process, therefore NCP for A T minus of 400 Kelvin is equal to NCP for gas B and 700 minus of T. Number of mole in both the chamber is 2, therefore 2. Cp for diatomic gas is 7 by 2 R T minus of 400. Number of mole for gas chamber is 2 and Cp for monatomic gas is 5 by 2 R, which is 700 minus of T. Now by solving this equation, 70 minus 3500 5T. By solving this equation, we will get T is equals to 525. Now, we have to calculate work. We have to calculate work in this process. So, work is defined as, work for isobaric process is defined as W is equals to NR delta T for chamber A and NR delta T for chamber B as both the gas will follow isobaric process. Now, number of mole is 2, R is R and change in temperature is 525 minus of 400, that is 125. Number of mole is 2, gas constant is R. Now, change in temperature for this chamber B is 525 minus of 700, that is minus of 175. So, minus 175 into 2, minus 350 and 2 into 125, that is 250. 250 R minus of 350 R will give work equal to minus 100 R, which is option D in the paper. Therefore, answer for question number 14 is D. In question number 15, by applying equation of continuity, we can say that A1 V1 is equals to A2 V2. Velocity at the left part of the question is 5 millimeter per second and the radius of this chamber is 20 millimeter, therefore 5 pi into 20 square is the area of that chamber. Now, as the gas reaches to the chamber, velocity is unknown V and its area is pi into 1 square. By solving this equation, we will get V as 2000 millimeter per second because the unit of the velocity is millimeter per second. So when we will convert this into meter per second, we will get 2 meter per second, which is option C in the paper. Therefore, answer for question number 15 is C. By applying equation of continuity, we will get the answer C.